Okay.
Okay, guys, so this is a rare thing. I don't normally do these presentations. It's normally done by MJ, but I'm just so excited about these projectors that this is one of the few ones that I needed to do for you. These are called our Epson Powerlight series, and the reason I'm so excited is because they work and they are so forward.
Okay, guys, so this is a rare thing.
The whole thing was about the last game. It's
normally done by MJ, but I'm just so excited about these projectors.
These new puppies last 6 months, so they double the lifespan, and they were only about $300 more expensive.
They were so amazing. Okay, guys, that was a very cool thing.
So you're going to check out the last time you see friends on any day,
Primary, well, the Chromebooks are built in this way, so it's nice to use primary.
It's gonna work for all the student devices. So I got laptops spread around here. I have Chromebooks spread around here. If I wanted to pull out my iPhone, it would work. If I wanted to pull out an Android phone, it would work. These things work on everything. And that's why I said they're so futuristic. These things can last us for about 8 years, whereas in the old days, they were 4 years. And then also, you can use it whenever you want to do several clients at once. That means today we're going to do a little tutorial. I'm going to have you guys connect all these devices around here to this one projector. And provided our internet doesn't crash, we'll see what happens. Okay, so the audio. That's the other big announcement with these. Up until this year, we did audio where we did these speakers kind of set around the classroom. Speaker quality would quickly break down due to teachers putting too high of music or whatever else would occur. I trialed those audio speakers with INS and I've had an experience. So the cost and everything else, we're probably going to be switching to just these for our audio in the future. This summer, I'll probably have you guys yank out all the old audio. But the audio is actually pretty good on this, especially on the one that I bought last year. It works wireless. So if we end up, for example, getting 2-in-1 laptops next year, those are things you can write on and put all the way around. So you're moving around as a teacher now with your laptop in your hand. It's a super lightweight. You can dream with the audio you're doing to them. It's trying to create this futuristic technology classroom. And you see the really, really high-end schools going to, but we've been slowly marching through the last few years. All this kind of comes together by the start of the school year. Let's see. Only one video source at a time can transmit audio. We'll see in a minute why that's realistic. But Chromebooks and tablets do not transmit audio. So only your MacBook or your actual Windows laptop will do this. It's really important if you start to get kids with their Chromebooks and they want to show you a video, it won't do the audio part because it doesn't have built-in drivers. Those are only built into your traditional laptops. Okay, so the controls. A few different areas on this. These remote controls, while all great and everything else, the most buttons you need to know is LAN. It stands for Local Area Network. Think of this as Wi-Fi. And then your HDMI video. Oh, and the power button. Everything else is not that big of a deal, but a few things you should be aware of. This is like a TV remote control, so you got your normal up and down things. You have your navigate projector, volume controls. All can be done right here. Remember, you have volume for this, but you have volume for your laptop. So if you mute your laptop, it's going to mute this. If you have your laptop blaring and this is muted, it still won't work. So you have to always check both audios if you're ever projecting. Wirelessly, it makes no difference on that. And then you can always ignore the pin mode because we have smartphones here. And then a few other things really don't apply to how it's set up. So this is really, really basic. I'm hoping not everybody loses it. But in case they do, there's a backup option. You can actually do the remote controls from your laptop or from your smartphone or your tablet in your classroom. So we won't be replacing these when teachers lose it. Instead, we'll just say, well, you lost it. You can be able to go online and just control your settings or use your nice little tablet. So there's something called an IP address. This is like a domain, like google.com. Similar. Each one of these puppies has a unique IP. That's their IP address. It shouldn't change. So that way, once you add it into yours, you can be able to go back to it anytime. Once in a great while, it changes in the application, so let's double reference it up. Password for everything is the same as Epson West, all caps, lowercase and min. Don't worry, I will send you this PowerPoint so you have these nice little answers to the slide. But this will let you go in and instantly be able to access anything that you might need to as far as your control panel. So if I click right here, it actually has me. To log in, I would actually be able to right now control all of my volumes. So see my volumes going down? Volumes going up. It's identical. So, what I wanted to show you guys today specifically is how to work the wireless. Because the wireless is the most important part of it. And it's really trying to bridge you from what I'm potentially going to do later this year with Refresh, which is trying to get teachers away from there to where they can be the most mobile objects in their classroom, as well as the students. So we have this little button called LAN. LAN right here, it will pop up. To get your IP for the first time, you just hit LAN. You will get this nice little IP address right there. Does everyone see that on there? Okay. I'm going to go take my laptop off and try to get a leader before I have you guys this. open up my Epson app. Everybody should have an Epson app that has brand new projector. And when I get to my Epson app, it'll ask me, you know, whether I want to do quick or advanced load for the first time. And then after that, it'll never ask again. My goal right now is to quickly connect to the projector.
Everybody should have an
Epson. Notice how? No more ports? Wireless is future. I'm nerdy right now. So on your screens, because I'm going to connect real quickly on the projector, on the moderator right now. You can see my screen, right? Franchita, did you kick me off mine? Where is this feature? Click the zero register to this one.
So on your screens, I'm going to connect to you with another projector, the moderator right now, see my screen right
now.
So on your screens,
called class one.
Okay, so I'm in. Now what I want to do is quickly get you guys into this. So if you're running, let's say, a classroom exercise, and you want to be in a sharing exercise where kids are literally popping stuff up on the screen, you're going around, you're talking about whatever project you're doing, you get in first, and you make sure that you register as that moderator. That moderator is key, because the moderator is essentially the captain of the ship. If you don't, just quickly exit out and go back in. For you guys, the Chromebooks, they can't become moderators. It's good. So all your little PYP kids can't do it for you. Just
make sure that you register as that.
The secondary students, when we install this app, we purposely install it as a student. And so they would have the basic code so they couldn't kick you out. Only the admin installer will actually be able to kick you out so you can make other staff members playing pranks on you. Hopefully it's not that bad. To get you guys into it, what I want you to do is find the Epson app on a tablet or a Chromebook that's in front of you or whatever you may find. Yeah, we're just going to get a bunch of you guys in here real quickly. Someone named Darth Vader just logged in. If you've forgotten your IP address, 172.16.52.155. And I'll show you how to do that in just a minute. Just let me all on to start this out. So we're going to manual search. It might be because you're on an old thing that has firewalls.
172.
We are. So good. This is a promo. Anyways, don't be as good to listen to those ones. I figured out why. It's because you know my name. Okay, so about all of you are in this. So the biggest hassle of this is, of course, getting you in on the very first time. The kids are actually in the secondary, for those of you that they've kind of figured out already at the IEPs. But for the little ones, it'll take a little bit more time. With the number not changing that much, you can actually make like a little postal sign in your classroom with those numbers and big letters to quickly find them. But as you saw, you all were able to connect through different devices. As long as one, you're connected to the network, and two, your firewall settings are set. For all the kids, it's already been set in secondary. Chromebooks are more applied to, iPads are more applied to, just a select few teacher each of the laptops that we might still have to have. Not too bad. So, I can have between 30 and 50 max connections of this. For the models right there, it's 30, for the new ones, it's 50. The big, gigantic Epson projector actually in the auditorium will also be in 50. So it runs off the same thing that these do. So you can actually use wireless speaker up there, and hopefully get to test that and see how it works. When you log in, you see how mine says B. Fisher as the captain of the ship. If I ever needed to get my information, there's an I button. You'll see it when I'm on a small screen. You'll see it when I'm in the big moderator view. Always look like that. Right? Your control panel, remember the little remote control? Find down here in case I ever need that quick link that I want to save to. So you get in, you can automatically go back to your remote control. You shouldn't really need to, but you never know. So we're going to start out with this. I'm teaching a nice lesson for all of you. And I decide that I want to get four people also in my lesson. So I'm going to add this group. As you can see, I'm just clicking and dragging. I'm going to add this Mora. And I'm going to add this Anakin Skywalker. I'm picking this Mora out. I'm going to teach you a nice lesson for all of you. iPad. There we go. I can control how many screens I see at once. So I'm going to start out with one. And by hitting the little two-person thing, it's the top two. Now, I can see Marinji, Karuko, or whoever's on this screen moving around. And I can see B. Fisher. But in addition, let's say I don't want kids to be like looking at my screen. Maybe I'm doing stuff as a teacher. I just want them to kind of look at other people's. I can quickly freeze mine using the pause button, and now I'm quickly running around, moving my laptop around, I can go to other websites.
But in addition, let's say
I can still see the two out there. Then I decide I want to get all four kids up one at a time because you know we're doing something really interactive. I'm going to take myself out by simply clicking my name, dragging me out. Notice how the black screen appears there, and I'm going to put this D Vader in. If I would click down here, I could show the second two, and the top people that were originally there are gone, but I'm still in a view of two. Can't see now, but I'm at a four-person view. So let's try to figure out who the four-person views are. And you're going to notice some differences for those of you who have iPads, which is why I want to do this study, so you can see the functionality limits of a tablet versus Chromebook laptops. So I got three laptops and one iPad. Who do you think the iPad is? Who is EBL15. If you have an iPad right now, what I'd like you to do is you'll see a little grid button. Click the drop down menu and go to, let's say, camera. We'll figure out real quickly. And ask if you want to access it, click OK. So whose is it?
If you have an iPad,
makes it really interesting. Oh, hi. There I am. So on a tablet, this is for your briefcase KG, if you take out your iPads from the library, because this does work on primary and secondary libraries, they both have a system. You can have four tablets running at once, but the tablets cannot access any app that's on your screen. In fact, you have to use this app to access stuff. So whose is this? Rashawn, can you go to the one that says website on that little grid? Now, Rashani's on a web page, so if she wanted to show something on her screen, her choices are basically a camera, photos, some things you've already taken, or videos you've already taken. It'll actually give you access to your video screen. And then, of course, websites. The Chromebook will show anything on your screen like a computer. So for those of you in primary teachers, you can get your kids' stuff up there so you can get them connected at the beginning of your lesson. It'll take a few days for them to learn, they'll get it. Once they get on this, you can actually, if you want, as a classroom control mechanism, you can just have four screens popped up at once. Or if you're doing something more interactive, they'll see whatever app they're in. As long as they're in the system, they'll be fine. I told you a bit about being a moderator. So as a moderator, there my moderator view, and I have this little button right here that switches to a toolbar view. This lets me kind of just do whatever, I can ignore it. And some additional features right here. Do you notice how my play, stop, and disable buttons are completely disabled? You can't see on your screen, but on mine, they're all disabled. The reason why is because I'm not one of the four people currently projecting. So if I'm the moderator and I take myself out of those four people, my controls are really limited. But if I pop it back up, I can quickly take Darth Vader out and put Pete Fisher back in.
Can you interact though while you're in that position? So, for example, if you're on an iPad and it's touch screen, can you go and touch screen that iPad, what you're projecting? Can you use the touch screen function on the smartphone?
You're in the iPad app.
So, for example, Prashama's got the iPad app going.
Okay.
Let's say it's a picture,
because okay.
That's the easiest. And then I wanted to circle a part of her app.
You want to circle?
Or someone in the classroom wants to come up
only
to the projector.
Only Prashami could be able to do that. However, I haven't touched this in detail, but I do believe if you have a smart board, there are things that will override the smart board that could potentially do that to get around. That would be if you literally have one of these ones
or
someone in the classroom. But by default, now, Prashami, and actually in a minute I'm going to switch and make Prashami in charge of the class. And Prashami's going to be able to take photos and she can start drawing on it and do whatever she wants to see it as a live screen.
You can't actually physically do that on that screen.
No, that's great. Okay, so this button down here is the one I told you about. This is a really important button. This lets me take back control if I start having a bunch of other kids on there. And a minute ago, I can't find my name up here. See how there's no B. Fisher? There is over here, but a minute ago, there was no Brad. If I needed to, I would be able to simply go to click this button to project my screen and kick everybody else back out. There is, of course, a stop and a pause button right here as a standard teacher. This is just no different than the remote control. Stop links the screen. Pause. Let you freeze the screen so you can do whatever you want while kids are working. You can also just use a remote control. You don't have to log into this program. So switching tunes now. I want to get out as quick as a moderator. I don't want to be a moderator anymore. If I click this button, it'll ask me if I want to relinquish my moderator controls. I'm still in this program, but I am not the moderator. Prashami, at this time, in Prashami's app, her little, she's got a 3-digit grid up here. Become moderator. Click OK. Now on your little lines, click your lines. And I want you to go click. Let's go to multi-means device projection. Prashami is now in visual. So for whatever reason, Prashami's trying to give her kids control of the whole system. And now the kids in the box. Prashami can quickly remove. Go ahead, just click our first button. Anakin Skywalker. Okay. And if you want to put an indicator in there. She's up there now.
So for whatever reason, Prashami
and then you want to go one person grid. Now it switches around. So this will get you the ability, let's say you're doing a dual teaching between a teaching assistant and another teacher, or two teachers going side by side, and you need to kind of go back and forth and work with each other. Plus, for whatever reason, you might want to actually give the kids control. Go ahead and start using your name. Let's see what happens. Pause one, move something else.
Teachers go side by side, and you need to kind of go back and forth.
So she's completely gone crazy on me. And while she's doing that, I'm going to go to YouTube.
Brad, how do I know that she's. Can I know that she's.
Whoever's the moderator said. So, of course, I'm going to hit one of my little Star Wars things because I love my Star Wars and I'm a total geek. I can't hear any volume from that hall. Prashami, as a teacher, if you wanted to go back to a one-person view, based off that, how could you get me and me alone presenting?
So of course I'm going to hit one of my little Star Wars things.
Yeah. I want just Brad.
I can't hear any
volume. There you go. And now, you press that Brad button.
Prashami, as a teacher,
one Brad. There you go. She's hit Brad. Once she's done that, before one is playing that, these projectors are not complicated. I mean, I literally spent a long, long, long time before I committed to this marriage with these. But they are easily the most powerful things I've worked with in education before, and they're cheap. And only a couple hundred bucks more than they're buying.
Yeah, you should.
Questions about these. Now's your time to play. Ask if you know they want to these. Because they are literally going to be in your classrooms for a long time.
So go back to the iPad thing. You can't mirror an iPad directly.
You cannot mirror an iPad directly.
You have to mirror to your computer and the computer.
Correct. If you're trying to show good old-fashioned apps you're doing besides just a website, it is great to use these for if you're doing websites or photos or videos on your hard drive. You have specialized apps to go through a different mirror. This is really better when
you're trying to show good old-fashioned apps you're doing besides just a website. It is great.
Any other questions you guys may have?
Just the Wi-Fi.
I pitched it for this year.